Salamta, fellow Rastafari. We wish to share with all Rastafari and those willing to receive, I guess, like a quick little review of this week's Rastafari Sanbet study, which began from the book of Genesis, chapter 25, verse 19. And our main focus is simplicity, so we are going to try to keep this simple and just I guess give ones a visual aid to however it is that this may help, if indeed it helps any, then so be it, basically is what we're trying to say here. So let us continue. Basically, what's taking place is Isaac is kind of old now. He can't see very clearly, and so let us just make mention that Isaac is kind of limited to his sight or vision, and so we can say that he is kind of behind a veil. And Isaac intends to bless Esau, his firstborn, that natural born individual. And that is because Isaac, if we kind of use the mind as a type of Isaac, the mind tends to lean towards the flesh, and we all know that. We all know that there's kind of like a favoritism, always the mind kind of having a secret allegiance to the flesh, to Esau in this case. But Esau, the first Adam, could be like an Esau. The first Adam was made a living soul, but the second Adam is to be a quickening spirit. Now, up until there is intercession done for Jacob, Esau takes off and he is hunting and he's preparing that venison for his father Isaac, but Rebekah intercedes. Now Jacob is allowing things to be how they are to be. He's not really thinking much of anything, but Rebekah, being represented by the spirit, Rebecca intercedes for Jacob, and like a quickening spirit says, Jacob, hurry, like grab by a kid from the goat, so that I'll quickly prepare venison that thy father so desireth, and therefore so that you may be blessed instead of Esau. So this is the spirit interceding for Jacob. Jacob's like, okay, all Jacob had to do was fully fill his role and responsibility as being the younger child, one born of spirit, of the promise, as Abraham is revealed to us and is a perfect example on the way to walk, and how he went forth on faith on that promise made to him. So now all Jacob has to do is listen to the voice, in this case, of his mother, of the spirit. And surely enough, Jacob fully fills his role and responsibility and listens to the voice of his mother, and therefore he becomes blessed. Now, intercession of the spirit, Jacob being the younger and being born of faith and spirit, the promise, Isaac having a veil, not beholding iniquity in Israel, Esau the flesh. Now Esau gets upset, so this creates a certain kind of contention. Now it is necessary to make mention that we do not destroy the flesh. It is there. We only have to come to accept that it is there, and so move on ahead, where we cannot be, where our path in this spiritual growth cannot be obstructed. So this creates a division. The spirit, the voice, the mother, Rebecca, of Jacob, instructs him to leave to Laban, his brother, her brother. And Laban is a white mountain, we could say. And so the instructions was to leave Es Esau was really upset. Esau even cursed himself by saying the words that by uttering those thoughts that he so did. So now the spirit is telling Jacob to leave the situation, to flee. Now, in our present state, we don't necessarily have to leave anywhere physically, but we do have to leave the present battlefield and move on to a higher state of mind, to a meditation of positive vibrations, symbolized by Laban and Jacob going to the spirit's brother. And so another aspect of the mind. But basically, we know that the flesh will have, the flesh will want certain things that sometimes are not what we know in spirit to be true. We cannot destroy the flesh, but we must accept it. And so basically to not so that we no longer continue complicating our lives, just accepting it is half the battle, just accepting the contention. But finding a balance is the ultimate key. Don't ever think that your problems are will one day be resolved, and one day you will no longer be confronted with difficulties. That is not the case. We just have to know and be willing to receive the fact that you reach the top of a mountain only to find that there are more mountains up ahead and some even higher. And so that is life. We must accept that every day will bring forth its challenges, but we must find a peace, a state of mind in which that will not affect us. And so this isn't a competition of trying to work out all our problems. That is not how it is to be. But we do have the choice of avoiding a lot of potential harmful incidents by escaping and fleeing to a higher state of mind in meditation. First, we must turn to the Almighty Creator of all that is good, and then we must look deep within ourselves. Spend a minute with yourself. Be quiet. You don't meditate. Just forget about everything. If it happened that the flesh, triggered by the mind, aroused some kind of discomfort and now you're upset, then meditate on it, but not in the spirit. Retreat to a higher ground, to a higher vibration. Just relax, and it'll pass away. You'll be overcome. You'll overcome as we have already overcome. And so basically we could even we do not have to be controlled by the situations. Rather, we can take the initiative of creating, forming situations more desirable for us. Just this is the main key, fleeing to the Almighty and reaching a state of peace. Just think about it, meditate, contemplate, relax, and take advantage of whatever situation might have been presented to you, and as rather than see it as a complication, see it as an opportunity, a challenge to become bigger and greater than we have ever been. Now, and it's even mentioned that Rebecca does not want Jacob to mingle with the daughters of Canaan, and that is kind of like stay away from your emotions, Emotions will drive a person mad and crazy. So do away with emotions. That is very necessary to understand, but just try to reach this location, this peace, this comfort. You don't have to be tormented by every situation. Just relax, no matter what it be. You got a ticket. Just pull off to the side and park there for a minute and just think about life. It doesn't even have to be thinking about the ticket itself. Just let your waters be more, what's it called? Be not stirred up. Let your waters levels be level. Excuse me for that, but we don't want waves of kind of emotions and attitudes and stuff like that. I mean, we're seeking a solid, a calm sea. Vibrations in which our higher states of mind can flow, empty the vessel. You see, this is the depression, and this is the taking on the pressure, the burdens of life brought by Esau. But then we pass over to a higher state of being, which is everlasting, ever present, ever existing, being what it can only be, living always. Now, here is the turning point, literally, the turn of the key. If you reach this point and you pass over, this isn't necessarily passing by. This is passing over the flip side. Look at the good side, the spirit. The spirit prevaileth, and the body benefit little. So here we have, in a way, our covering, our umbrella, our shadow, our safety. And if all this burden is overcome and your vessel is empty, poured out, so I mean, this is kind of, we didn't even think of going that far, but if it helps once, then so be it. Just clear your mind. I mean, we're not saying forget about your problems, but just let them go for a while. Relax so you could get to a point where you can even think clearly. We had this instance where a friend of ours, roommate at that time, female, she got really upset with her boyfriend at the time, and she was about to call him, and she was out of control, and in the spirit of the moment, being that in those times I and I was not aware of Ras Tefri within I and I. But basically we just said, why don't you relax, calm down, let it go. Enjoy. We were having like a, I guess like a get together, and I made mention, why don't you just hang around and wait for tomorrow when everything is cool and calm, and if you feel the same way, then go ahead and call him and say that which you were going to say now. And so that really helped, because her emotions, her waters, her energy and levels were unpredictable. Rage, mood swings, emotions, attitudes. But it on in the grace of time and patience, the next day she was able to wake up at a fairly level stream of living water, and not death, right? Not like a seesaw, like jagged and pointy corners that cut, and only, we're not gonna get into that. But basically, she was able to come to the conclusion that if she would have responded, or reacted rather, in this state of mind, she probably would have created more problems than were actually at hand, but it all has to do with relaxing. Think about it. I mean, don't break up with your girlfriends over something really quick. Girlfriends, don't break up with your boyfriends. Think about what one says. Think about, I mean, just give yourself time to come to a relaxed state in which you can actually make a good decision, a decision in which you've been influenced by the Almighty, and your willingness to be calm and to listen, excuse me, to listen to that voice within the eye, and make your wills obedient to a righteous judgment. And so we think that that's basically, we didn't even think to explain or go this far, but we, that basically pretty much sums it up. And so for now, we give thanks to all and all. Shalom. Rastafari.